What's going on, guys? I'm Nathan. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm going to be answering some of your questions that you left for me on my Instagram channel, Instagram page, sorry. And I'm going to be taking you through my session as well. Welcome to Zone Gym, my humble abode. Let's go.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. Like I go crunch, grab and bite. We can go bust, eye for eye. We can lose trust, white rum, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up, catch my vibe.
So I'll usually spend about 10 minutes warming up before I touch any weights. And always starts with the foam roller. 5 kilos. My body's a bit battered, man. I'm supposed to be deadlifting today. So I need to make sure that I really warm up. I'm just gonna play by ear with what I can lift. Are we saying, what, 6 plates?
Boy got peas, now she hopping in the pod, man, a real life sugar gal, and I forget what. When she want dark, told her meet me at the top. Switching lanes the other day, I seen her waiting for a bus. Maybe this a Moncler sweater, diesel denim. Buy another one, my pockets fat like heather. Neck froze like I don't know no better. Benzo truck, white seats and they leather.
Right, so first one, quite simple. How did I get into fitness? I've been training for a long time, like literally over 15 years now. Main reason was to just look the part. I was studying to become a personal trainer and I thought that I needed to look the part to be the part. So that's why I started training so hard. But one thing I found along the way is that I learned so many things about myself. Before I started, I was very shy, lacked confidence, very introverted as well. And me starting this journey, it helped me feel better about myself, be more confident. Forced me to get out of my comfort zone and come into an environment like this where I am forced to socialize with people, and it's made me the person I am today. So without me starting my fitness journey from just becoming a personal trainer, I wouldn't be the person I am today. All right, resting. I'll do another question. Oh man. Someone said, how soon should I start taking supplements? But listen, one thing that you need to realize is that all a supplement is used to fill in a part of your diet that you may be missing out. So if you take, sorry, protein, for example, if you are required to eat, say, 200 grams of protein a day, and you are struggling to get all of that from food, then that's where you may think of introducing things like whey protein powders or maybe protein bars into your diet to fill that gap. So a supplement isn't a magic formula. Don't think of it as like that.
Fucking hell.
Where's he going? There he is. That shit hurts. Fuck me. One of those exercises where you don't give anyone any eye contact. Someone asked me, what gear am I running, bro? All right, let's just clear this up. Don't do any gear, no SARMs, nothing. I am 100% natural and I have been always. That is it. Do I track my calories and my weight? Yes, I do. Reason being is I want to try and stay in shape. So after my show, I'm trying to stop myself from binging and gaining weight drastically, and I'm enjoying my routine at the moment. I don't want to get too heavy again, so I want to try and track as much data as I can, and it'll help me stay in shape for as long as possible. Man, you got, thank you, bro. All right, so what do I do for cardio? My weight, my set before was like cardio for me, so I try and get the majority of my output from my weight training. That's my number one I don't think anyone should, if your goal is to change your body composition and add muscle into your body, then you shouldn't do more cardio than your weight. No more than a half of your total training session. So if you're doing weight training for an hour, then your cardio shouldn't be no more than half an hour. But what I usually do, I've got two dogs. I will walk them, usually in the evenings, for about 20, 30 minutes a day, and that's pretty much it. Or if I need to make up my steps, then I might walk on the treadmill after my workout. But that is about it. I'm fairly active throughout the day with my job. I'm a personal trainer as well. So me on my feet, that's enough for me. Whilst I'm in between sets, I'm actually using this one. I didn't want to get it on video because it's a little bit suspect. but back to the questions. Cheat meals during my off season. During the off season, and how often personally? I don't really class food as cheats. I'm past that stage now. I feel like anyone who is pursuing a fitness career or just wants to better their health in general, they should be eating majority of whole foods anyway. They can get away with having about 85 to 90% of clean foods, and then say 10, 15% of their calories can come from whatever they want. So how often do I do that? I'd say once or twice a week. Once or twice a week. So today's Saturday, and tonight I'm going out to have a free meal with the missus. So yeah. Got one set of extensions. Just to top my quads up a little bit more for the week. Then I'm going to carbs, my absolute nemesis, but I'm determined this year to actually develop a good set of them for the summer. So I've got that, and then I'm going to do a little bit of biceps and abs, and that's the routine done.
Grind, she make it clap like I'm Busta Rhymes. I got the juice, the sauce, and all them things. I blammed her twice a night with all my bling. Big Benz, I drive, I brought that ting. Any girl you want, they want my ting.
Don't rush, slow touch, grind on white. Like I go country, grab and bite.
Right, so someone asked me the best way to learn how to do bodybuilding myself. First of all, get a gym membership. Best thing to do is just start. The things of this game, there's you're always going to learn. You know, like now I've been training for like 15 years and there's still things that I'm learning now. So there is no end to this learning game. But what I recommend, number one, read. There's loads of stuff on the internet now you can look at. Influencers are constantly posting information on social media, but if you can, to save yourself the best time, you can also hire a coach, hire a personal trainer. There's ebooks that personal trainers or coaches sell online, so there's loads of platforms you can go by. Find what's the most convenient for you and just stick to it. It's alright, I'm holding on to it, man. It's not like fucking dialed in, but it's not bad for off season. Asked me, could I find a reason, except a medical reason, that could stop me, that could make me stop training? No. Especially when it comes to weight training, I personally feel that weight training is the best form of exercise that anyone can do. I think more for longevity, if you can actually think about how long you can do this for, you can do it forever. If you're to compare it to a sport like football or basketball, there's a life expectancy time that you can only do it for, but this, you can adapt your training so you can do this for a long period of time. As I stated at the beginning of the video, weight training has helped me be more confident and feel better about myself. So No, I'll never ever take this away from me. Weight training is my life. So guys, that is me done for today. Thank you all for tuning in. It's been a pleasure. Please, if you can, to support these videos, will keep getting better and better. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all again very, very soon.
Quiet wrong, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, with they go up. Catch my vibe, let me go off. Blam the trash, man it's so tough. Flood my eyes, make a whole blush. Back of the tour bus, getting cool up. D-square, got them de-stressed, got a hand wash.